Hello, good morning, good evening, good night to some of you guys. Thank you for coming to stream this early. Welcome, people. Hello, hello. Hey, man, what's up? Thank you for tuning in. Anyway, today we have 3.3c patch notes. Ooh, definitely not leaked. Definitely not spoiled by Wild Riot themselves. But hey, welcome in. Dude, I hope you guys have a nice fucking Thursday. Holy shit. It feels like yesterday was only Monday. I can't wait, man. I can't wait for 3.4 for new champions, because I feel like the meta is so stale right now, and I feel kind of lost though. Not gonna lie, like I don't know what is actually fun for me now to play. Like, the patch notes was abysmal. Why? What's wrong with the patch notes though? All right, let's since we have some time. We're gonna also wait. Let us go through the patch notes, and then we'll see what we can do. If you're from YouTube, hello, welcome. Do subscribe. I'm waiting. You done? Thank you, man. This is the patch note 3.3c, made by Alice Freya. How do you say Endstep's name? Nick Freya. Freya? Freya. And Sean. I don't know. Who the fuck is this guy? I should get to know this guy. Anyway, Camille. I think I mentioned this plenty of times on stream. Like, this champion can't be nerfed because basically the kid is so busted. You have a soft CC, you have a hard CC, you have a lockdown with the ult, you have a fucking shield and the passive, you have true damage. So this thing is like impossible to nerf unless you completely disable the fucking kit. So what you see right now is just a small adjustment. Instead of a flat 2 second slow with the W, you get a decay slow. I don't think that will change anything. Hook shot, you got to increase, a huge increase, and I mean 6 seconds at level 1. Holy shit. Maybe instead of maxing Q, no, it's still maxing W into Q into E, cause the passive for Q, the true damage, scales with levels, so it's still a E, W, Q and E max. But there's a new tooltip. If the dash hits an enemy champion, hookshot's cooldown is also reduced by 5 seconds. Oh, so you need to be accurate with this. Okay, so what I do understand from this is that one of the devs said that you shouldn't be using Camille's E to run away so efficiently. So it's more of an engaged tool right now instead of like. So I don't know. Hextech Ultimatum is also increased by 10 seconds. They're just downright nerfing this champion, and they don't want Camille to be played, I guess. Corki is our next buff. Would this be considered as a buff? Camille is dead? I don't know, man. I don't think Camille is dead though. I think 2 to 3 nerfs before that, we already thought that Camille was dead. But look at where she. I'm having a 12 game win streak with this fucking champion, man. Okay, but Corki. Package duration is down by 15%. That is okay, I guess. They're trying to revive Corki because nowhere in high elo did I see Corki being picked as consistently as before, right? Even in pro play, Corki is just dead. Mainly because of the rise of Stormrazer. Like, Stormrazer, this item is just too valuable. And with Corki, you have to go like... What's the first item? What's the first item called? The crit item that gives you mana? Essence Reaver, yes. So, because of Stormrazer's buff, Corki is just insignificant in the AD carry role. Maybe right now, after the changes, they will be played much more as a flex champion in pro play, like she's being used in... Is it she or he? I don't know. Corki has been used in the mid lane and AD carry role. A flex champion. However, though, one thing that reminded me was in pro play, it is... it wasn't being picked as much because of Hullbreaker nerf, because we're glad that this champion is not flexing with Hullbreaker. Alright, Gatling Gun base damage. Oh my god, there's so much tanks. So instead of just physical damage, right now they changed to magic damage, like all together. So there's no more physical damage. Resist reduction is increased by 2, 3, 4, and 5. But the tick is now increased as well. Wait, resist reduction per tick. Huh? So total resist reduction is this, but the reduction per tick is that. Okay, that's interesting. Missile barrage, which is the old recharge, is 10, 9, and 8 seconds. Oh, that's pretty good. Now it scales with level as well. Fiora, this champion is also kind of dead unless you're playing it to counterpick someone like Yax. Hello? Like this champion that... Okay, the next one is Yax, but let's talk about Fiora first. So, Fiora hasn't seen the light of day in the meta, mainly because of a Q nerf, and the Q nerf is just insanely bad. Like this champion feels more like a counter pick. It's not as strong as before. It's not a first pick potential kind of champion. It's just bullshit. Like, I don't enjoy Fiora as much as I enjoy her before. I feel like that she's really weak, and that's it. But they're increasing the health though, so maybe she's much more of a tank bruiser now. I don't know, but I'll still see people buying Triforce into Borg and then into Death Dance or something like that. But yeah, I think after this buff, I don't think she's like first pick worthy or like a prioritized pick either in pro play or high elo. Now Yax is terrorizing the top lane meta right now mainly because of the grass on the dying buffs, and this champion is just bullshit. You know, you can E, and then you can trade grass on the dying proc, boom, and then once you hit level 2, you can boom with the E and then pounce on the guy, gap close, hit the fucking nipple, bro. This champion is just giga busted. A 6 damage reduction is just a discount. It's just a small discount. I think Jax is still pretty relevant in the Baron meta. But we'll see. Kassadin? Our previous nerfs were powerless against Kassadin as he's still overperforming in higher levels of play. What? Do they not know that Kassadin is actually insane in late game? I mean, yeah, it's just a small minor nerf. It's just tickling the fucking Kassa mains, you know? 11 seconds, 10, 9, and 8, so one second across the all levels. Base damage is also reduced by a little bit. But that's not the thing about Kassadin, though. The thing about Kassadin is you can go tank, and you can buy Fimbulwinter, and this champion will still bust your fucking ass. It's so broken. The scaling is just through the roof. I don't know why they're not doing much more about Kassadin, though. They're so aggressive with like champions like Camille, Fiora with the nerfs, but Kassadin is just, they're just tickling his balls. This nerf is nothing. Alright, Pantheon. Oh, Mantis? What the fuck? Comet Spear, which is the Q, Mortal Will Empowered Damage, is also increased from 100% to 110%. Nice. A small, tiny adjustment. But that's it. That's the enhanced Q, though. Aegis Assault, which is the E, the shield, it's decreasing cooldown. I think this is pretty good. In the early games, you would only pump one into E. So 18 seconds instead of 22 is a huge, huge buff. I like that. Renekton isn't as snappy as we like, and he's still falling off in the later stages of the game. Really, bro? Really? They're buffing the health again. So now it's a total increased max HP at 2.4k at level 15. Pog. Alright, I still don't know where Renekton stands right now in pro play or high elo meta. But I guess he's like a solid pick now. Camille still playable? Yes. Unfortunately, I will tell you, the nerfs onto Camille is irrelevant. I'm pretty sure I could still perform her. I'm pretty sure she still feels not as strong, but maybe could still put up a fight in a mid game to late game. Because they're not changing much about Camille's kit. I think the only thing that's broken about Camille is her kit. Like I said, strong CC, soft CC, you have fucking lockdown with the ult, you have mobility with the E, you have fucking true damage, you have a fucking passive that blocks damage too. Like, what the fuck is that? That champion's kit is just broken. Teemo, this champion should be yeeted out of this fucking meta. Or not even close to fucking be picking in ranked. This should be a PvP and an ARAM exclusive champion. So stop buffing this champion, please. Jesus Christ. Passive movement speed is increased. Nobody gives a fuck. Active movement speed. Nobody gives a fuck. Guerrilla warfare. Nobody gives a fuck. We move on. Vhagar. Well, this Tanning Master Evil locks down on his phone and definition of pain. Okay. Really, bro? Cooldown. The cage cooldown is increased by 2, 2, 2. And 2. What? Why? okay, that's I think Vhagar as a champion is not being used at high elo. Maybe it's just mid elo and low elo. Like, nobody plays this champion. If you play this champion, you're... Why play Vhagar when you can play Kassadin? That's the thing. Like, they're not buffing... They're not balancing the champion. And they're not looking at other examples. Like, if you were to put Vhagar in situation A or Kassadin in situation B, like, who do you think would survive? Vhagar has burst. Yes! But Kassadin has fucking mobility and burst! Bro, this shit is so weird, man. I just don't understand. Kassadin is just way too OP. Gameplay changes, item changes, goggles, enchantment. Since our rework to the enchantment system, okay, this enchantment should be nerfed. I agree. Like everyone from my grandma to my fucking dead grandpa is buying this enchantment in team fights, including AD carries. This is fucking cringe. As an AD carry, you don't need shield. You don't need this item. Like, why? It's so cringe. This item is so cringe. And I'm glad that they nerfed it. ADCs are also running. Yeah, that's the thing. You could be a support, you could be an AD carry, you can be a mid laner, and you could still buy Gargoyle's enchantment. Like, what the fuck, man? This item is broken to a point where other roles are just yoinking the shit out of tanks. So very nice tune to the raw max HP values. I think you're just bringing too much value, man. I don't know. I don't really know how to feel about the GA nerf, though. I feel like GA as an item is very valuable. Yes, you get a second extra life in team fights, but don't you think it should be nerfed? There are plenty of other ways to nerf, though. Maybe you can adjust the damage. You can adjust the cooldown timer of the respawn rate, like the cooldown, maybe from a minute to like maybe 3 minutes. I don't know, make it more taxing. But hey, they do what they do. Increasing my 300 gold, just farm one more wave and you can get it, I guess. Maybe one wave and one camp. One jungle camp, it's easy. It will just slightly delay your GA power spike. Magnetron enchantment, nobody gives a fuck about this. I think it's just useless. Swap it for something like, I don't know, Prowler's Claw maybe? Magnetron, like, like why? Maybe you could do like Frostfire Gauntlet, maybe? That would be insane. You could do a lot of Wombo combos. Bro, make Frostfire Gauntlet 1,000 gold, like GAs, right? You could do a lot of... You could shift the meta so much, and it's so fun. Maybe you could do, like, Frostfire Gauntlet RE Charm. You could do this, do that, and, like, just like in PC. Don't you think so? Like, this is so irrelevant. Like, nobody uses this. Not even Blitz mains. Or whatever the Taunt enchantment. Is it this one? I have no clue. Navori Quick Blades is getting a slight buff. With the overall gold and the passive cooldown if you hit the crit, so that's pretty good. We'll see what this how this item feels, and 200 is, it's actually easy though. But I don't think this item should be picked up as a first item. 2.9k is kind of cheap though. If you were to ask me, you provide some attack damage, some crit, and you get passive cooldown. So I don't know. This is really interesting though. Navori Quick Blade. I don't think it's a first item worthy kind of thing. Yeah, on Lucian or Xayah, but wouldn't you want to get IE? You get a huge damage burst. That's the thing. All right, we'll see about that. Lunar Goddess Diana. Oh, Devas and Ira will be excited to get the skin. Looking kind of bog though, to be fair. Releasing September 9th, 8 p.m. for us. Hey, I mean 8 a.m. for us. Okay, that's pretty good. Free to play champions, I don't give a fuck. Okay, overall, I think this patch is really minor. There's nothing huge about it. I guess it's a meh patch. W skin? Wait, how W is W skin? Wait, let me see. Lunar Goddess. Let's go on YouTube and watch, you know? You can always do that. Lunar? Wait, Wildry Spotlight already released this? What the fuck? So fucking fast. Whoa, the gaze though, you get my, okay, looking kind of basic, oh, but it's pink, oh, yeah, it's like an in the between of a pink purple hue. The passive looks nice though. Oh, I mean, Well, I have to see the ult. Wait, is that flower petals? No shot. The Q? Oh, I thought it's like a rose or something. Boo. Alright, where's the E man? Where's the E man? Where's the W man?
I cannot turn back.
Oh, I like it. It's like the W is really nice. It's bright, it's contrasty. Is that a lotus? Oh my god. Whoa, wait. Ooh. This is like a very Chinese themed skin, I guess. You have the lotus, you have the moon. It's like very medieval Chinese.
Follow no false light.
Wait, it only costs 7. Oh, wait, what? Whoa! Whoa! Kinda dope though, not gonna lie. It's Japanese or is it Chinese? Oh my god! Even the... Wait, they even did like the small little effect? Like the lunar eclipse? Wait, is it just me or is the Diana ult like faster now?
Twilight Fade.
Okay, maybe not. No. Okay, it's too slow. But why would they want to keep... Oh, look at this. It is a full eclipse. And it will be a partial eclipse if charged to like the maximum. Whoa, the small little details, man. Very nice. Okay, I guess that's pretty... That's not too shabby, right? The rest, I think we've seen it all already. Yeah, so there's nothing much. Very interesting. They just released one skin. Like, that's so weird and random, right? They just release one skin in the next patch. Wonder what they want to release, like, two or three. Okay, that's kind of weird. Not gonna lie. Man, I need new playlists. Like, these playlists are actually kind of sad, though. I need some upbeats. With like, you know, it makes me feel like want to rank. Play Riot Music. Oh yeah, true. The new Riot Music are pretty pong though, no? The new Valorant music. Hey! Hey! Dude, swap. This is Star Guardian. Oh, it's kind of trippy though, not gonna lie. I canceled it! What up, Babega? I don't need leash. Fun fact, it's actually faster for you to do the wolves first than to do this, even with leash, because your E is like so good. You can just spam this. Holy shit, dude. Alright, level 3 gank incoming. Hola, amigo! Wait, what? We can't kill? Why did I flash anyway? How the fuck? How the fuck? Are you joking? Ah, I'm stuck, help. Wait, it literally has no ward and he fucking moved at the last second. What the fuck, dude? I'm actually getting played. Bruh, low elo is making me guess myself. Holy shit. Actually, should max W instead of E though. This guy has no blue. Oh, and this guy survived. Fuck you, man. Also, Amumu is another champion that can do this. Ah, insane, right? I know. Did this back in season 0. Alright, time to go home, collect the blue. I mean, collect the red, gank bot, maybe. 1 minute. Oof, not too sure about the 1 minute, though. How long is my ult? 80 seconds. Oh, you could probably do this and the red as well. Oh, I'm so fucking annoying, dude. Oh no. I wasn't expecting you to ult. Ah, we still got it. I don't think we should die though. Can we just go this? Guys, guys, I'm buying time. Go home. Oh no, it's not leashed. Okay, now it's leashed. Kaylin still hasn't go home, so I think we're strong enough to actually fight this. Help! My god, why is it so tough to actually get a fucking objective, dude? Just shove the bot wave, shove the mid wave, and then play for the objective already. He doesn't have ult. Wait, he does. I like this man. Can we just do it now? Oh my god, Camille is here. Are you fucking kidding me, man? Hello, team? I'm sorry, Salsa Pandas. You will be the sacrifice.
Shut down.
Hey, Kimochi. Enough. You yoink my fucking kill. That dude also got executed. What the fuck? Bruh, I'm a support instead, man. This is no fun. I'm getting no kills. I hate this life. Don't leash it. Thank you. Very nice. That's very good. I'm just gonna boom topside. Whatever, man. Oh, I see you. Me come. Come here. Ooh, man. Not me.
Enemy slain.
Let's go la. Salsa with the zoning ult. Actually insane. Okay. Let's go. Nice try. Oh shit, we can't lazy recall. Run! We can't lazy recall. Run. Just run. Fucking hell, dude. Oh my god, this thing is actually killing me though. Execute it. Hey. My brother. I'm just gonna leave it at that, yeah. No way I'm joining that shit. Dude. Okay, y'all survived. Very nice. Oh my god, this guy is still chasing though. Hello? Wait. Execute don't work that way though. You don't just stand in the turret doing nothing. Oh, here comes a flank! A Mumu flank! Hello, where do you wanna go? Whee! Another one, maybe? Oh! The sun knife, the predictor of the blast cone. Wait, I'm a fucking genius. Dude, I'm actually a fucking genius. Nah, no way this guy actually fights me, though. Woo! I'm hot. I'm actually so good. Moomoo main? These are actual fucking mechanics that you should know. Me dodge the small, like, what do you call it, trap? Wait, this guy was taken already. Yikes. Alright, I need to go home. Alright, let me get this shit. Maybe getting this would help though. Ooh, it has AP ratio and Amor. Was that double clip worthy? Kind of. I mean, it's low elo, so it's easy to predict. But it's funny though. Immediately flashed. Wow, dude. Holy shit, I'm thick, bro.
Hey, Kimochi!
Let's do the Dragoon. Wow, Diana is having it easy, you know? Like, wouldn't it be nice if you could just push and your jungle is doing all the fucking work for you? Bruh. What a good life. Just imagine. Actually, Amumu is pretty fun. Amumu's ult used to have like a 150 second cooldown, or maybe less. 120, 150. Now it's only 80. So that's pretty good. Aha, nobody gets my shit, bitch. I wouldn't suggest pushing topside, but sure. Let's just go. Why are they running though?
Hello?
That actually hit though.
Help!
Unstoppable. Ally slain.
Ah, let's back. That is not a bright thing to do. We still can be seen, so we gotta camp here. Okay. I got this item. Let me go get this item. We be pogging. That was a custom Spider-Man Amumu skin back in the day? Wait, what? Oh, custom. I thought Riot themselves released a Spider-Man. You know why I liked Heroes on New Earth? That game, because you could use custom skins as well. So you literally don't have to pay for anything. And you can just mod the fucking game. That's what makes it so fun. Ooh, they should be scared of me though, to be fair. Look at this massive PP flank. I'm gonna do this. Boom. Oh shit, I missed. Wow. There are so many traps, my guy. Oh, huge Hugo! Oh shit, not.
Yeah!
Wait, where are all teams, man? That was a huge ult, but there was no follow up. Instead, Raven was split pushing. Ah, so sad. Whatever, dude. At least we got an inhib. Oh, they patched it. I mean, of course, if you're talking about, you know. As a in a business standpoint, if you see people not buying skins and just using custom skins that could be modded for free, would you not want to ban it or patch it? Oh my god! Wouldn't you want to stop that from happening? Of course, man. Like, it makes sense. How the fuck am I 6-1 and 16? Dude, I'm actually popping off. I'm pretty sure we have to end soon before they outskill us. So let me take the Dragoon. And then we can finish off. I am fucking this thing cooked me. Now you have to die. Oh, you motherfucker. Okay, imagine fighting without me. That's so cringe. Ooh. You don't have to always outflash though. Ooh, you have to Q flash. Right? That's how you fucking play this champion, my guy. Ah, help! I'm dying.
Victory!
That was a fun game of Amumu. I really liked it. And thank you all for coming. Don't forget to join the Discord though. Let me just and subscribe to the YouTube channel. I'll catch you guys tomorrow for another stream. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. Yes, actual raid. Please show him some fucking love, yeah? He deserves more attention than I do. I promise. So, go there, say hi. And enjoy your spare time with Nstep. He's a really nice dude. And have a nice day. Go say hi. Bye-bye. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye. Have a good fucking night. And I'll see you guys... soon.